Good evening, everyone. A massive shift in government strategy for COVID vaccinations has been announced by the centre yesterday. After many demands from states, they have liberalised the procurement, also the eligibility criteria. Now, states can procure some of their doses directly and can also decide which categories they want to vaccinate over 18 years of age. Here's a quick breakdown of what has been announced. States can now open vaccination to any category of people above the age of 18. That decision now rests with them. States can procure additional vaccine doses directly from the manufacturers. Remember, from the state center quota, they will continue to get what they got. 50% of the vaccine supply will now be available directly in the open market and to state governments. Private hospitals can procure vaccines exclusively from this 50% basket. Prices for the private players and states will be determined by the manufacturers. Also, imported fully ready-to-use vaccines can be given to states and private players. Central government will not make use of them. Center, though, will allocate from its share of 50% to states based on various criteria, including wastage. Wastage will go against states now. Vaccinations at central government centers for now will be free of cost to all above 45 years of age. Now, if we take it for granted, if we assume that all states will begin vaccinating all above 18 years of age from May 1, it is of course going to be a mammoth challenge in numbers. According to the 2011 census, the population above 18 years is 73 crores approximately. The population that has been fully vaccinated so far is just about 2 crores. Around 11 crore people have received their first dose only. So the doses that are still to be administered is around 130 crores if we want to vaccinate everyone above 18 years of age. These numbers are of course approximate because remember the census for now is not available. We are relying on the numbers from 2011. Dr. Ashok Seth, Chairman Fortis Escorts Heart Institute, is joining us on the show. Dr. Narinder Kumar Mehra, former Dean, All India Institute of Medical Sciences and also ICMR National Chair. And also Professor Dr. Anita Ramesh, Professor and Head Medical Oncology, Savita Medical College and more, joining us on the show. Thanks a lot, gentlemen and ladies, for joining us. I want to go across to Mr. Mehra first up and ask you, what do you make of the challenge that India faces right now? There's about 60-70 crore people who have to be who can be vaccinated now from May 1.
Well, India, you know, India has been the first country to launch the massive vaccination drive. India has also become the first country to reach the 10 crore mark. India will now be a country that will open the vaccine to everybody from May 1 onwards. Mm-hmm. So I think the challenge is very large, but I really believe that this new schema that the government has come up with would actually help in vaccinating more and more people, because our target should be that by the end of May, we should at least target 30 crore, if not more. And I think that is achievable. I may give you an example of UK. You know, we are here in India talking of the double mutant, and everybody sees, it's something very, very great has happened over there. It's not something like that. We have seen the same thing happening in UK in January and February when our numbers were going down, their numbers were going up. And they had a strategy that they wanted to use their vaccine at a gap of 12 weeks so that they could vaccinate as many as they can. And that helped them a lot. And today you see that the numbers have gone down, significantly down. They're not seeing more than 2,000 or so everyday infections, and their number of deaths have gone down. The second point I want to make here is that there's no need to panic. We need to vaccinate. Our death rate is not high. Mm-hmm. Our death rate has actually plummeted from what we used to have, 1.4 in the first wave, to something like 1.15. So I think we are in the safe zone. So the only thing that is happening is that this particular new strain has clogged our hospitals and our infrastructure is going.
Yes. But if you just want to focus on the vaccine challenge for now, Dr. Ashok said, I want to come to you. What more clarity do you have on how private hospitals, for example, can procure what they want to do? And what range do you think that price is going to be? That's the biggest question in people's mind right now.
Yeah, at the moment, there is no clarity on this. I think it's too early because it was yesterday that the decision was made and announced. And of course, as is seen, the next few days are going to be important in actually streamlining many of those objectives and those aims and objectives which came up in the document yesterday. Let me just say that, you know, you think that this is a huge challenge, and it is. But so is the election process in our country. That's close to 1.3 billion people who go to the polls. And yet we actually do it seamlessly in the best possible manner. And many of those election processes just happen in a day. So I think we've got to understand that the machineries are there for every aspect. And the combined machinery of the government and the state moves smoothly when it and seamlessly when it wants to. So it is not that issue that you say, okay, it's been very difficult to vaccinate. Actually, there's, you know, while you say 13 crores is a huge number, in a percentage of the country and the percentage of who we wanted to vaccinate by July, August, it is still a small percentage. But really, the crux of the matter is hesitancy. There's still a huge element of hesitancy. There was some aspect of lack of availability, but that'll be overcome. By the way, that was primarily because there was no incentivization of the manufacturers. They have the ability to produce 100 million doses per month. And that's 10 crore, that's 11 crore doses a month, provided there was incentivization and provided they had easy options available to ramp up those. Remember the time when 3,000 crore were asked? And there was a lull and a silence, and that, you know, we know that now that is in there. You know that the 3 crores and 1,000 crore has been given to Bharat Biotech and 3,000 to Serum Institute of India. Ramp up of vaccination production is going to happen. India is the biggest vaccination hub of the world. Coming to whether we can vaccinate or not, in the last couple of months, I must say that we've been disappointed as private centers because we have had the ability to vaccinate twice the number of people we could have. And yet we were sticking at those 40-50% range, not because of lack of availability. The vaccine was there. It was just that the people weren't coming forth to have vaccination. And that was more visible in ages beyond 60 because people felt they're anyway going to be in, they're anyway not going to go out. They've got comorbidities. And in fact, the very reason why we want to vaccinate them, which was comorbidities, were the reasons they weren't getting vaccinated, saying, oh, but I've had cancer, I've got heart disease, maybe I shouldn't get vaccinated, I'm too elderly, we shouldn't get vaccinated. It's the younger lot. For every one elderly who doesn't want to get vaccinated, there are five younger people who do want to get vaccinated because they've got to be out there. They've got to be dealing with the world. They've got to be earning their money. They've got to support their family. And they've got to also support their parents.
So in the long term, of course, it's important. And we have to move into that direction.
And by the way, we're going to see these manufacturing processes go really up. We're going to see the availability go up. We're going to actually have systems into place to cater to those. And I'm very clear that we're going to see vaccination double and triple rapidly over the next few weeks and months with the availability even of Sputnik V coming in. And five manufacturers making them. But the crux of the final question you asked, what is it going to cost? That's going to be the important part. And I think government, when it's opened this up, is clear. It's not going to be 150 rupees and it's not going to be 250 rupees. It's clearly decided that it's going to cost a reasonable amount so that the vaccine manufacturers do get the returns, that people who can buy them and afford them do pay so that they can subsidize the poor, and the government is going to offer it for free.
Exactly.
And the rich will subsidize the poor. And finally, it'll become a win-win for all. It'll become win-win for the government because they don't have to cater to the whole population and pay for them. There'll be the rich who'll pay more. That money will go to the manufacturers, and certainly part of it will also go to the public because that will be subsidized. And I think this is the point going forwards, and that's why this is now a partnership rather than an imposition, rather than a mandate.
Okay, I want to bring in Professor Dr. Anita Ramesh here also. Now, the question is not so much whether we can produce so many vaccines, because just today, Bharat Biotech also announced they've ramped up their facilities. They are capable of producing 700 million doses now in a year. If you divide that, then monthly also, we can get a good share of what we need from Bharat Biotech alone. At the end of this month, we could get 10 crore ready-to-use doses from Sputnik. And of course, Serum will also ramp up its production. So the vaccines will come. There's no denying that. The issue is whether we can handle the rush at the centers. Do you think states should open up directly to all above 18? or do you think some of them will still go in a staggered manner, because that choice is with the states now? Dr. Anita? Ma'am, if you can hear me, can you please unmute yourself? We are not getting your audio.
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yes, please go ahead.
Can you hear me now? Hello, can
yes,
you hear me?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, so what I feel personally is that, yes, we are in a position the world's hub for vaccination, and this is not the first disease that we have vaccinated, but yes, we have vaccinated many in the past and we have done really well. But the situation is different now with the huge pandemic coming in, with large crowds of people who needs to be vaccinated. Yes, what you said is right, and I agree with you. It is quite a difficult process, and all states will not be able to cope up with the present scenario. Three of the states doesn't have they had just finished their elections, waiting for the new government to come in. Mm-hmm. And the remaining states are also, many of them, the lockdown has started, large number of COVID cases, shortage of bed, and even the healthcare system is also crippling a little bit compared mm-hmm. to last year, because the cases are very high. So I do agree with you. It will take some time for all us to ramp up, to get the more vaccines like how you suggested coming into the market. And as just for information, you know that 50% of the production should go to the government. That's what the health authorities declared yesterday. Mm. And the remaining 50% should be by the outside players, yeah. Private.
But do you think states will open and up to all above 18 from May 1?
Yes, there'll be a big rush in the primary health center government, but I think we'll all be able to cope up. The Covaxin app will be there. We have to bring in more people. We have to give them slots, times, or avoid overcrowding. And also we have to see that at one area, there should not be any wastage. Wastage of vaccine should be less than 1%, and then bring in more players, more affordability, and bring in all the private, even the smaller centers, which are all small OPDs or the OPs which are having doctor's chamber, has to be opened up so that there's not much of crowding in the private hospital. And as we suggested earlier, to open up campaign door to door for those people who cannot come to the hospital, that also helps to smoothen it. I'm sure we'll be able to get into the whole process. There will be hiccups, but then overall, we all, not only the government, it is healthcare as well as we citizens ourselves needs to put in all our effort to see that yeah. the vaccination process.
Dr. Anita, if I may just come in here, two questions that are foremost on everybody's mind, and Dr. Mehra, I'll come to you with one of them. States can decide if they want to open up to all above 18. Do you anticipate that states will actually do that, or they will still go and maybe lower the age criteria a little bit, because influx of people is something that they will have to handle?
So yes, I think you are very right. It is up to the states, and the states can decide depending on the number of active cases that they have. Mm. You know, vaccination for all is the key, and that has been shown by a number of countries' experiments. For example, I want to take the example here of Israel. Mm. Israel has vaccinated the maximum around the world, and their numbers of COVID infections and their the hospitalizations have actually gone down drastically. Same thing is true of UK and many more. So I think here is an opportunity for the states to think about themselves. They can plan. They can plan depending on the size of the population of the state, depending on the number of infections that they have, depending on the number of deaths that they have. All of those criteria will have to come forward. And the states will not be in a situation then to all the time blame the center. I think here the onus is now being transferred onto the states, and that's a good thing to my mind.
Hmm. No, actually, what has happened is that states wanted some liberalization. That is exactly what the center has now done. They continue to get the support from the center. And at centers, the central government centers, the vaccine is still for 45 plus as it stands right now, even from May 1, and it is free of cost. But states wanted that they should be able to lower the criteria. I go across to Dr. Ashok Seth with that question, and also one more question. The percentage of those in the eligibility criteria today, those who have been vaccinated, is so low. What makes us think we can actually... you know, get that many more people in and vaccinate faster? Because the ones that are already eligible, doctor, they themselves have not achieved saturation.
So you must remember that if you limit it to a group and the group has a greater vaccine hesitancy, you will actually be sitting around with 50% utilization of resources like we were doing and like many other private centers were doing without actually being able to vaccinate individuals. And that could have been taken up had we opened it up. Now, I want to address one very important point. In your question is an inherent belief that there is going to be vaccination centers still happening in private. Well, what liberalization means, and government will still have vaccination centers where people will go to. But what liberalization in itself, you will see what gradually happening, is that if you can actually buy the vaccine of a pharmacist, then anybody can actually buy a vaccine, and any doctor can actually give a vaccine. In fact,
you
nurses,
think that will,
you know,
that will happen? Because right now happens, the government says that private
vaccine.
Hospitals can procure it.
You will see this gradually opening up. This is the first part of liberalization. So you're automatically assuming that we'll still have centers, we'll have loads of people flocking up to that center. No, liberalization is left to the states, and gradually what will happen is small nursing homes, doctors, general physicians. At the moment, every vaccine is given by pediatricians, general physicians, every doctor. In fact, it's the nurses who are administering it. And by the way, the earlier issue about 30 minutes wait looking for side effects was actually true, that in the initial stages of public enrollment of any vaccine, you actually need to understand and wait for side effects. With a 13 crore population already given in our own country and in other countries, that weight issue, that systematic issue, that supervision issue is not going to be there. And in the next 2-3 months, you will actually see this vaccines being given at every general practitioner, at every physician, at your personal doctor, at every point and place, because this is how vaccination is given all across the board, even presently and in the past.
Dr. Seth, can I just ask you, you're saying there is greater vaccine hesitancy in the group that was already eligible right now. It will be less so in the group that will now become eligible. What makes you say that?
Because I'm their doctor, and I'm right in it, and I'm the one who's actually convincing those very people day in, day out, to have vaccination for the very reason they should have it. Believe you me, even now I get 50 phone calls and WhatsApp messages from my patients saying, "You put 3 stents into me. Should I really take this vaccine?" And I say, the vaccine was meant for you. That's why we opened it up for you to actually have it. They say, "I'm 80. And I say, "My dad at 97 is the first one I took for vaccination because he's a doctor. And I got him vaccinated at the first dose in the first 3 weeks of vaccination drive." Why, even at the age of 78 and 80, are you actually thinking? You would be surprised at the number of elderly who are still not vaccinated because of, not because of lack of it, not because the vaccine wasn't available. We actually have sat there waiting with vaccination doses for people to come, telling you ourselves that we only could achieve 75%, and max I know could achieve only 50% of their whole what they could have done, because they were ready to actually work 24 hours. That is vaccine hesitancy, and we needed to overcome that in a huge manner.
If I go by numbers that are available right now, again, approximate, because we don't know exact number of those above 45 years of age, then I think only around 4 crores have got their doses, like at least one dose. And those who have been fully vaccinated is even less. So there is a problem. We haven't really achieved great numbers as far as the age groups are concerned. We are just about nearing 50% benchmarks for the healthcare workers and the frontline workers who were the first one to start getting the jab. So I want to go.
I'll just say one more thing. If we open it up further, the hesitancy will be go lesser and lesser. I can guide you as that as well.
Okay.
Because like I said, for every one person who is hesitant, there are also three others who are actually very keen. And it's the younger generation who's actually keen because they understand that they have to go out, they have to be in the public, and they have to work, and they have to earn their bread and butter.
Right.
That's why it's so important for them to be vaccinated. They know it. They understand it more and more.
And because you're making that point, Dr. Anita, another point that needs to be emphasized again and again is that while vaccination for all is important and everybody should go and get vaccinated, the other challenge is that you should not still think that you are invincible. The young already seemed to be thinking they were invincible. We were not seeing COVID-appropriate behavior from them. After vaccination, we shouldn't have a situation where the young feel we are invincible, we've got a vaccination, now we don't need to wear masks, because you still need to.
Yes, you're right, because vaccination doesn't give you 100% protection. If you see, Covishield data is 71.70.1, Covaxin 70, and if the Sputnik comes into the picture, it's around 90. Nobody gives you 100. Mm. What it means that if I vaccinate 100 people, 70-80% of the people or 80 of them may not get the virus infection, but definitely another 20 will get the virus infection. Mm-hmm. So that's what efficacy means. And also it means that it is better to get vaccinated. So even if you are vaccinated and if the virus comes once again, it's a milder form of the infection. It's an asymptomatic infection. You don't need ICU, you don't need ventilator, you don't need higher drugs. So vaccine acts in two ways, 70-80% protection of not having, and even if you have, it's a milder form of. But then we should not let our guards on, because our pandemic is not over, and the second wave, as you know, it's coming in a very bad way. The cases are rising. I'm still sitting in the hospital, I'm in the vaccination center at this point of time. So large number of people, ambulances are coming in, there are huge shortage of bed, and being oncologist, many of my cancer patients are getting positive. So a message to all the viewers, wear your masks wherever you go, never open it, maintain social distance, use sanitizer, follow the COVID appropriate protocol.
Right.
And as in my practice, I have already, all my patients, first thing I say, have you taken the vaccine? No, doctor. Please go and take it. I have this. Please take it. It's a big thing. So vaccinate everybody and follow the COVID appropriate protocols. Yeah. And we have to all work together. It's not a blame game.
Yeah.
We citizens, we healthcare workers and media we have to all work together, because none of us was prepared for this pandemic.
If you want to be secure, then vaccine is one of those shields that you can employ. So if the government is now making efforts to get everyone vaccinated, we'll have to wait and see what strategy the states employ individually, because the call is with them now. If you're getting the opportunity, please go ahead and get yourself vaccinated. As our doctors said, more centers, more availability of vaccine will happen. So it need not be just at the centers that are there right now. We'll wait to hear from the government, of course. Some details are still pending, especially on price, as far as these private centers are concerned. The pictures running on your screen actually are from the Prime Minister's meeting with vaccine producers. You can see the Serum Institute. I could see Bharat Biotech, Dr. Ella as well. We're seeing many more who are actually participating. Yes, Adar Poonawala of the Serum Institute is there. Dr. Reddy's representatives are expected to be there. So these are all vaccine producers who are actually currently speaking to the Prime Minister. And today only, at least Bharat Biotech has announced that they are ramping up. They are ready to ramp up. So they've made their arrangements, including raw materials, packaging, etc. They're saying they don't need to depend on imports anymore. They are ready to ramp it up to 700 million doses a year. That's 70 crore doses a year. But you can say that around 5 crores a month, for example, 5 to 6 crores a month from just one vaccine maker. So, of course, if others pitch in, India can have enough. That is no longer the issue. The issue is the logistics now. Time for a very short break. Of course, our focus on that meeting will also continue. Stay with us.